this site and get a web version of Xfinity. It's got all a lot of channels too. Or DirecTV Now, another one, which is a internet-based package. You can get all of those. You can get the Hulu TV version of it. They got a Hulu Live TV version, but it's all kind of choices. And with me comparing all of those, I decided to roll with Sling TV because I wanted to have my sports. I wanted to have, I think it gave me at least local Fox 5. It didn't give me any of the other local channels. And it gave me, I think my wife likes OWN. It didn't give me OWN, but it gave me BET. Like, some of them didn't give you BET or VH1 and stuff like that. Not that I watched that, but it's like I wanted to have that choice of having that. So, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it is that you like in between, you know, what channels you're looking at, you need to compare those and roll with that. And if you want to watch movies, you know what I'm saying? Some people say, you know what I mean? They were watching like Cody, but Cody's now gone. You had to go with something else, man. I now use a alternative. They have APK files that you can install directly on the Fire TV or on your Android boxes or on your computer, whatever. But they have these APK files which allow you to get direct apps. With these direct apps, you no longer now have to use Kodi, because you had to have Kodi with the plugins. These plugin makers actually have their own applications that you just install directly and watch. So I've been watching one called Movies HD, which is an APK file installed now on my Android box, my Fire TV, etc. And you know what I mean? It's just like Kodi. Some movies may work, some may not. But hey, so that, there it is. You got some movies that have not come to TV yet, fresh off the fresh out the cinema, may still be in the cinema, but clarity of the movies. Some of them, some may be bootleg, but you can, you know, watch or not watch them. But hey man, I'm happy with that choice. So now I got internet, I got Sling TV, and I'm using my boxes for the movies, you know what I'm saying, these movie packages. And if you don't have a certain channel on Sling TV or whatever, like since it doesn't have local channels, but yet you still want to watch a show that comes on CBS, NBC, or ABC, you can just get the ABC app and watch that episode or that show. You know what I mean? It may be later on that day, but hell, you don't have to watch it live, do you? I mean, hell, my kids don't watch it live, so I'm like, shit, it was all about seeing as a consensus what everybody, you know, watched and what their viewing habits were. So cutting the cord was an awesome thing as far as being able to choose your package and your apps and just get rid of that shit. So it's out of there. You know what I'm saying? I'm laughing at you, L, saying that I got the hookup. No, man, for real. There is, RC said, you gonna write this down. Yeah, RC, there is an app called FireDL. Anybody listening here, if you actually uninstall your Kodi. You don't need Kodi anymore. Kodi is tripping out there. The plugins ain't right. You got to change your bill. There's an app called Fire DL. That's Fire, F-I-R-E, D-L. You can do it on your Fire Stick. You can do it on the Android, Google Play Store, whatever. Get the Fire DL. Once you get Fire DL, there is a, there's codes that give you the plugins. So instead of having to know the URL, the website of these plugin websites, you use the code and you put it in FireDL and it will download directly to your thing. That quick and that easy. You put the code and you hit download and it installs it. You don't need to know the URL of those plugins, how to get them, etc. Where you get the codes from, if you go to FireDL, once you download it, it will have a website right at the top that tells you to go to get the codes. When you get the codes, it's like hundreds of codes of all kind of plugins, builds, websites, movie site, all that stuff. You do it, try them out, man. See if you like it. If you don't like it, uninstall it. Go to the next one. But I'm telling you, it's the new thing, man. FireDL. It's the main new thing that you need to jump on and handle. You know what I'm saying? Forget Kodi. You know what I'm saying? Go to that new out there, man. It's the new way of being able to enjoy those movies. And it's not a, like I said, it's just a downloader. FireDL stands for Fire Downloader. It's just a downloader. Some people aren't real good with saying, okay, go get popcorn time, go get this, go get that, go, you know what I'm saying? You're able to go get whatever it is you want based upon that utility. So, you know what I mean? That's that. That's my that's my tech tip of the day. You know what I'm saying, folks? Always like to watch movies, always like to be in the know and stay entertained in the evening, you know what I'm saying? So that right there is an awesome thing. This one right here, I'm gonna get in on you, is this crack versus opioid epidemic here, man. This is crazy. Y'all look at that, man. The opioid versus crack epidemic is crazy. I'm gonna break it down to you, man. Let y'all know how serious this thing is. We're gonna first hit the opioid side of the house, and then we'll visit the crack side of the house. All right. So with this opioid versus crack epidemic, there's an issue, man. I'm gonna just lay the facts out here and let you form an opinion on it, and then we'll convene at the bottom of that. All right. The opioid versus crack epidemic. All right. Every day, there's like more than 90 Americans who they die after overdosing on opioids. What they're doing is they're misusing opioids, which include the prescription pain relievers, heroin, and synthetic opioids such as fentanyl. They say it's a serious national crisis that affects public health as well as social and economic welfare. So the CDC, they estimate that the total economic burden of prescription opioid misuse is $78.5 billion a year, which include the cost of health care, lost productivity, addiction treatment, and criminal justice involved. So the stats behind is this. They say that 21 to 29% of patients prescribed opioids for chronic pain, they misuse them. They say 8 and 12% develop an opioid use disorder. And then after that, there's an estimated 4 to 6% who misuse prescription opioids. They transition to heroin. And they say 80% of people who use heroin first misuse prescription opioids. All right, so that's the stats that behind it. Now, this is the response of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. They're focusing their efforts on five major priorities. They said because of this epidemic, they're going to start improving access to treatment and recovery services. They're going to promote the use of overdose reversing drugs. They're going to strengthen an understanding of this epidemic through better public health surveillance. So they're going to provide support for cutting edge research on pain and addiction. And then they're going to have advanced better practices for pain management. Ain't that crazy? So that's what they're saying that they're going to do as a government entity about this epidemic. Furthermore, you've got Walmart who comes in and says that they're going to take on the opioid abuse crisis with a safe solution to dispose of unused prescriptions. So they're saying it's going to become the first national drug chain to offer a free opioid disposal option at all its pharmacy locations. So they're teaming with a company called Dispose RX on a solution that consists of a small packet with the FDA safe chemical blend that when emptied into a pill bottle with warm water, it lets patients dispose of any leftover medications in the trash. All right. That's what they're saying on the opioid side, right? That's the opioid side of the house. They've created that. They're creating it as a quote-unquote epidemic. They're trying to figure out how they can eradicate this. So that's one side of the house. Now let's go and compare this to the quote-unquote crack epidemic. All right, so you got the crack epidemic. First thing is, in the 80s and the 90s, the crack cocaine epidemic ravaged poor black communities across the country when crack arrived in economically depressed urban areas. It proved both powerfully addictive and potentially lucrative. Violent turf wars erupted as dealers fought for control of the market, and the grip of addiction caught many people. The government's response to the crack epidemic then was to double down on the war on drugs, first declared by Richard Nixon in 1971.
Then in 86, Congress passed an infamous 101 sentencing law, which treated the possession of 1 gram of crack, not the sale, mind you, as equivalent of possessing 100 grams of powder cocaine. This is on top of a 5-year mandatory minimum sentence for first time possession of crack. Now, did that sink in on you? So, it says, since black people accounted for 80% of crack arrests, black communities were hardest hit by this ultra-criminalization of crack, which sent young black men to prison at historic rates. The federal prison population swelled from 85 to 2,000, and two-thirds of those convictions were for drug offenses. Studies show that although blacks are no more likely than whites to use illegal drugs, they're 6 to 10 times more likely to be incarcerated for drug offenses. That's crazy, right? So, in response to that, yo, I got something here. This song right here came out during that time, during the crack era. Let's play this for y'all right quick.
Have you forgotten that once we were brought here, we were robbed of our name, robbed of our language. We lost our religion, our culture, our God. And many of us, by the way we act, we even lost our mind.
It's PETV with your anchors, Sherelle Winters and Flavor Flav.
Yeah, boy! Yo, bust the move!
In today's edition of PETV News, we'll explore the devastating effects drugs are having on our society and what is now termed the base hit syndrome. We'll also feature the controversial group Public Enemy and their new album, It Takes a Nation of Millions to Hold Us Back, which is causing a ruckus everywhere.
Here it is! This is a dope jam, but let's define the term called dope. And you're thinking me funky now, no
kidding. You know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, Cheryl, kick the ballistics, G.
Up front, an ultra-hyper faction known as the Brown Bags lodged a protest today against rap music.
Yo, bust this, man. Yo, listen to Flav, man. Yo, right here live, covering for the protest for PETV, live is my homeboy, Chris, man.
Yeah, I tell you.
Well, you know, Chris, all the rap noise and the violence associated with it is bringing our country to its knees, and we're not going to stand for it anymore. And we, the Brown Bags, have a plan to put an end to it all.
Here is a true tale, why the ones that deal, all the ones that fail, yeah. You can move if you want to move, what it proves. It's here like the groove, the problem is this. We got to fix it, check out the job.
This is MC Light coming live and direct from PETV. In the never-ending search for the base heads, we've come to a new hiding place. Yeah, that's right, Wall Street.
Check out the justice and how they run it. Selling, smelling, sniffing, riffing. And brothers trying to get swift in. Selling their own, rob a home. While some shrivel a bone like comatose walking around. Please don't confuse this with the sound. I'm talking about base.
This is MC Light from PETV. We're inside Wall Street searching for base heads. Let's see what we can find.
Together too. The bells of those that boost the dose of lack-a-lack and those that sell the black. Shame on the brother when he dealing. The same block where my 98 be wheeling. And everybody know another kilo. From a corner from a brother, keep another below. And stop illing and killing. Stop grilling. Yo, black, yo.
We are willing.
Just in this red alert. Chuck D, leader of the controversial group Public Enemy, has been taken hostage by the Brown Bags. We'll have more on this story as it develops.
Hey, yo, I'm not a drug dealer, man. Yo, get off of me, man. Get
this
off.
This ever happened to you, man, before? They think you're a drug dealer, and we know you're not. Well, now there's beeper tie. Yes, for a limited time only, for only $99.95, you can have your own beeper tie. To order, just call 1-800-555-1234. Whoops, gotta go. Beeper's calling.
to tell you something, man. You
Baby, why are you on the phone while we're on the air doing news?
Yo, man. Don't be stopping me, man. Yo, let me tell you something, man. They got my partner Chuck, you know what I'm saying? You ain't going to free him, and you ain't going to go see him, you know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, Griff, man, yo, later for her, man. Hey, yo, G, get Terminator, pack the van, you and S1, I'm coming to get y'all, man. We going to get